Welcome to the crime scene. We are so excited. I mean, you guys are really gonna rock the whole wide world. We welcome you back with a huge parade.
When the Commonwealth of Virginia seceded from the Union in 1861, one of the important federal military bases threatened was Gosport Shipyard, now Norfolk Naval Shipyard in Portsmouth, Virginia. Accordingly, the other was sent to destroy the base rather than allow it to fall into Confederate hands. Unfortunately for the Union, the execution of these orders was bungled. The steam frigate USS Merrimac sank before she completely burned. When the Confederates entered the yard, they raised Merrimac and decided to use the engines and hull to build an ironclad ram.
Swedish engineer John Ericsson was personally responsible for the Monitor's conception and the details of her design. Perhaps with Scandinavian coastal defense conditions in mind, he had been developing the concept on paper for several decades. What emerged was well-suited for the Civil War's inshore fighting, a relatively shallow draft iron hull topped by an armored raft that provided good protection against ramming and cannon fire. Freeboard was less than 2 feet, sufficient for coastal requirements, though a real problem when the ship went to sea. Engine power was modest, but again sufficient to the need, and the Navy requirement for masts and sails was quite approximately ignored. The most stunning innovation on a ship whose design was dominated by innovations was the method of carrying her guns. A thickly armored round turret, 20 feet in diameter, rotated by steam power to permit nearly all-around fire from a pair of 11-inch Dahlgren smoothbore shell guns, the heaviest weapons then available. At first sight, the Virginia looked like a floating barn roof.
On April 11th, after repairs were completed, the Virginia and a few smaller vessels again steamed out to offer the Union fleet battle. The Union fleet now consisted of the Monitor, the U.S. Naugatuck, a smaller ironclad, and many other wooden ships. The Union fleet refused to come out of the shore waters. The Virginia and small Confederate fleet held the harbor for several days offering battle, but the Monitor never took up the offer.
On May 8th, the Union fleet, now reinforced with another ironclad and more wooden ships, came out of hiding and began bombarding Confederate shore positions, while the Virginia was up the river. When the Virginia received word, she quickly started for the harbor. As soon as the smoke of the Virginia was seen in the distance, the Union fleet again retreated as usual.
The Virginia ruled the wave and protected Hampton Roads, Norfolk, and the river to Richmond. When the Confederates were forced to evacuate Norfolk, they decided to destroy the Virginia to prevent its capture. The Virginia was too large to take farther upriver, and she was not capable of a voyage on the open oceans. She was burned on May 10th, 1862, still undefeated.
The result of the battle was inconclusive. Neither side could claim victory. The estimated casualties around the battle was exclusive. The Union lost about 409 sailors, and the Confederacy lost about 24 sailors. The battle was so
impressive
to the leaders of both Union and Confederacy that they contracted their naval yards and to have more ironclad ships built. Additions to the Confederate fleet include the USS Tennessee, a 209-foot-long blockade running with 4 boardside cannons and pivoted cannons at a bow in the stern. Thank you.
one-hit wonder with an axe to grind. Another two-bit.